hopefully you watched the intro video for 1.6. And what I would suggest you do is try to answer these following questions and then come back and watch the video and see if you get them right. So I'm just going to go ahead and fill in the answers. And like I said, if once you've done it on your note sheet, why don't you come back and check to make sure you've done it correctly. So number one, circle the figures that are polygons. This is a polygon. This is a polygon. The rest are not. And if you recall from the intro video, the figures that we did not circle, the reason that they are not polygons, for example, this one, it has segments that go through the inside of the shape, okay? So you might just write something, segments go through the inside of the shape. This one here, and maybe I'll change colors to make it easier. This one here is not a polygon because it does not have, or because this edge right here is not a segment. It is a curved edge. So that one, the curved edge causes it not to be a polygon. And then the last one is not a polygon, hopefully, obviously, because of that gap. So the segments are not connected. Or you could just say there's a hole in it. Number two, which polygon is concave and which is convex? Hopefully from, again, the intro video, you recognize that this shape is convex and this shape is concave. Again, go back and write down those definitions if you haven't already from the introduction video. But I want to just talk about real quick, I think an easy way to remember the difference between convex and concave is I use the word cave. So I think about it in terms of something that's caving in. See how these segments or these edges are caving into the middle of the shape? So that's why it's concave. These segments are all pushing out. They're not caving into the shape. So that's just maybe one helpful hint to remembering convex versus concave. Remember from the intro video that regular polygons must have all congruent sides and all congruent angles. So circling the figures that are regular polygons would be this one. Would not be this rectangle because even though the sides are all the angles are all congruent, the sides are not. This is a regular polygon, and because there's five sides, it would be a regular pentagon. You can see from the markings that all five angles are congruent, all five sides are congruent. Underneath that, the star is not regular because even though the markings show that all the sides are congruent, the angles are not. Moving over here to the left, this triangle is not a regular polygon. First of all, there's no markings, so that really tells us nothing about the triangle. But it does tell us that it can't be regular because we don't see these kinds of marks showing us congruent sides or congruent angles. So then the last one here, yes, this is regular. This polygon is a triangle, has three congruent sides and three congruent angles.